Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Bot Squad Podcast. We are at episode number 47, inching our way close to 50. We got to do something awesome for 50.
Yes, we do.
We'll figure something out.
Yes.
But like always, I'm David. And again, like always, we're here with John. What are we drinking today, John?
We are drinking actually one of, I know, David's favorite beers. David digs the pills.
I dig the pills. Okay, you gotta say it right, because it sounds like I dig pills.
Pills. Pilsner.
I'm not a pill popper.
Pilsner. But short for, you know,
he pills. Digs the pills.
He digs the pills. And this beer is made by Carbach.
Another Carbach
beer. Yeah. They make a lot of good beers.
They do.
I think we've had maybe one that we didn't like.
I think so.
And
I'm actually really excited because I haven't had this one. Mm. I like the kind of beer, like John said, pills.
Yeah.
But I've never had this one specifically. Like John said, they're new, right?
Yeah, it's like a blonde wheat, you know? So it's not real dark, but it still, you know, has that strength of a dark beer. And right there, look, it says seasonal. It's crazy, man, because we're still considered winter, right?
Yeah.
And seasonal, they're already looking forward to... And all this going away, and
Z German,
and then
yeah, you got to do it.
And then on the well, okay, I do it, but you read that.
Oh shit!
Okay, okay. And then it says Ja, das ist gut.
Das ist gut.
It better be good. And I got a message for you on the side.
Oh man, okay. Braumeister. So a lot of things in Texas have been influenced by Z Germans, Z towns, Z water parks, Z sausages. And, well, even the beer. The German Pils is our authentic recreation of the Pils lagers in Deutschland. Pour the beer and watch the bubbles cascade down the top of to develop a puffy white head. Okay, I can't do this anymore.
You know what? You're just supposed to just read it regularly.
I went full German. I did. I hope I didn't insult anybody.
Nah, you're all right.
Oh, okay.
Woo.
Oh, das ist gut. Das ist gut.
Damn, that is good.
No, das ist gut.
Das ist gut.
Das ist gut.
Good. Bueno.
Damn it. Okay. Awesome.
Das ist bueno. That is good. I like that.
Was that like germ? I was going to say Germish.
I was going to... Yeah. That is good.
That is pretty good.
It has that hoppy-ass taste at the end. Of course, Carbach likes to do that.
Carbach has not really let us down.
This is...
I'm very happy.
This is good.
This is another good beer.
That is good.
I'm just glad it's not another... what was it? The Evel Knievel beer.
Oh.
Damn. That's gross.
Yeah.
A plus. So anyway, we're gonna go ahead and get right back into it. First thing I wanted to really talk about is the resurgence of X-Files. X-Files has come back after like what?
Oh,
13 years, maybe
something like that.
And everybody's going crazy for X-Files.
Bananas.
I will be honest and say that I've never really seen, like, I never got into the show. Like, I've seen episodes. I've never seen, like, a full season or nothing like that. Now, that I think that's going to change, though, very soon.
Okay.
Because I'm very... I hate to say that I'm going to jump on the bandwagon.
Okay.
Of everybody digging it, but it looks interesting to me.
Yes.
You know? So, John actually saw the premiere episode.
Yes.
Didn't they have like a, was it a two-part?
There was the premiere episode was an hour long, and the second one was 30 minutes.
Okay.
I have the second one. I haven't seen it yet.
Okay, well, you saw the premiere episode.
Yeah.
As you being a big X-Files fan, I know you've watched it for many years when it was, going on, right?
Yeah.
What did you think about the premiere episode?
Man, it was great. I mean, it's almost like... What, 13 years? You know, like, it was just...
Like it just, like, got right back into it?
Yes.
And without skipping a beat?
And it has, like, that movie feel, or it had that movie.
Okay. Maybe
I have, like I said, I haven't seen the second one, so that first one, it felt like you were watching the X-Files movie.
Oh, okay.
And just maybe that's just the way they record things now these days or whatever.
Digital or something, mm-hmm. You know?
And Mulder, like, man.
David Duchovny. You're like, he was never even on Californication. Like, he was just always Mulder.
Always Mulder.
Yeah, it's so cool.
Like, he never left the Mulder
character. No, he never did.
Do you remember on The Simpsons, what was it? FBI sexy agent or something like that? And he's like in his underwear. Okay. So was Scully too, but you know what? At the end of the seasons and when they started to end, she started. And she knows the truth. She knows the truth, and she's still so big headed about it. You know what I mean? And it left off right there. That it or it picked up right there where Mulder. I guess he's not a part of the FBI. Or he isn't.
He broke away from it and was like doing his own shit.
But that's what he says. And then he says, and he goes, I am and I'm not anymore. And basically she's just a physician or something.
A little bit of column A, little bit of column B.
But all in all, it was freaking good. It was awesome to see it back on TV. And
so were the episodes originally like 30 minutes?
No, I don't think so. I think they were about an hour.
Maybe they're trying to extend it, you know, longer.
But whatever, you know. I'm happy to
see
it.
It's just cool to see him back.
And right? It, just like how it left off, and it still has that cheesy little feeling to it, you know, like.
Okay, I heard that they still use the same title sequence, like with the song and all the beginning. Same one, right?
Yeah, same one. Yeah, I guess only because they don't want to
Mulder fall into the handprint.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. And the fingerprint. Yeah. And then, but, you know, they really don't want, I guess, to give away anything yet. Because if they do, then people, you know.
I get it.
And, but they kind of gave away a little something. Because on the second episode, during the trailer, Mulder, Scully calls Mulder. And she says, I have a file in front of me. And she goes, or something, you won't believe it, what it is. And Bigfoot. He's like... She says, it's monsters. She says, it's about monsters. And he goes, we're opening up the X-Files again.
Oh, shit.
You know what I mean? They open, you know, they reopen the X-Files and they're back on the case.
Yeah, I had heard something about that, too, that because people were kind of worried that, you know, well, if they're only coming on for, like, one season or, like, a part of a season then are they even going to, like, delve into like the creatures and all that stuff like they used to.
It seems like it.
And then the first thing that they said, no, there's monsters. So it's funny really? That you said that.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. So on your opinion, like from a scale of 9 to 10, I mean 9 to 10, 1 to 10.
I didn't do that. 9 to 10.
From 1 to 10, how do you rate it? For the most part, like you know.
All right, I'm gonna try to keep the fan part out. I'll give it like an 8.
An 8?
An 8, yeah.
Okay, that's fair. I think that's fair.
And it was so,
real quick.
Yeah.
Like the X-Files just come back, right?
Yeah.
We're talking about it.
Go to your like local Best Buy, Fry's, any, like, I guess, electronic store or whatever that sell DVDs. And when shows resurface and they come back and stuff like that, they usually sell like the box sets for cheap, and I got season 1, 2, and 3 like $10 a piece.
Oh yeah, I did see that they had individual seasons.
Yeah,
and then they have like a full box set out there.
Yeah,
it's like $100 and something bucks.
Yeah, if you go that route, it's gonna cost. Because what is it, like 11 seasons? I think they did.
Nine or ten. Yeah, because I was actually looking the other day on Netflix because I was like, I'm gonna start watching X-Files, and I looked and it said 9.
Sure. Because I know, like, the T-1000 was on maybe, the last one.
Yeah. He was, like, the main guy with Scully, right? So maybe it might be 10. I think. It's either 9 or 10.
I thought it was 11, mostly.
11, 12, 13.
Well, anyways, so I was lucky enough. I went and grabbed all those. And that was bull back then. And I remember sitting with my wife and just watching them. And I kid you not, and I hate to bring this up, but we kind of got into it a little bit. And... I recorded the episode.
Oh, I thought you said I recorded our argument.
No, I didn't record it. No, I put it on X-Files, and I was kind of ticked off at her and everything, and I went to the room, and I was like, Jay, X-Files is on. She came to the room and sat down, just like we always do, and we sat down, we watched X-Files, mad at each other, but we enjoyed it together, and it was good. It was so good.
It's just like those memes that I've been seeing.
Huh?
Of like, there's like a dog. Like with his paw on the driver, like on the master, and it says, when your girlfriend's mad at you because you didn't stop at Taco Bell.
Oh, wow. Oh, I saw that one first.
And it's like, you're like silently mad, but you still want to watch X-Files.
At the end of the show, we were talking. It was cool. X-Files brought us together.
Okay. Now, here's another question, though. It's funny because I never really watched X-Files, but I saw the spinoff show, The Lone Gunman. Have they showed up at all?
Those three guys?
Yeah.
I haven't seen them.
They didn't show up?
No, okay. The nerds?
I heard something about them, like, they were supposed to be coming back.
I hope so, man. I like them.
But for some reason, I don't know, I might be wrong, but I want to say that I remember them dying at the end of their show.
What?
Or something. So I'm like, how are they going to come back?
I don't remember.
I don't know. I might be wrong, though. I might be remembering
wrong. Can't kill a nerd.
Nerds. All right. So you thought, you know, you give it a solid 8 then.
Yeah. Okay. Solid 8, yeah.
That's good then. Like I said, I'm going to... It might take me a while to go through all the rest of the season, so I might just start off with the new ones.
Yeah.
And then start going back slowly, you know, to see certain things. I get the gist of it. Like, I know the Smoking Man and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And a lot of the main characters.
Yeah. They showed a bunch of them in the beginning.
Really?
They showed a lot of the main characters.
Okay.
A lot of them. And, it was just Mulder talking about the things that they've come across and stuff like that. And I thought that was real cool when they showed all those scenes and stuff. I just, man... Get back on it and start watching all the other seasons.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and move on from that we're going to talk a little bit more about 10 Cloverfield Lane.
What do you know, dude?
As we all expected, the whole viral marketing campaign thing is starting, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, already, I was looking into some stuff on the internet, and they already found, like, there's, in the trailer, if you notice, when John Goodman's doing the puzzle.
Uh-huh.
He has a drink right here on the side.
Okay.
They found out what that drink was. And they found out that it has a website.
Okay.
Called Swamp Pop.
Okay.
So it's like a craft soda, you know? Like, you know, like the Jones sodas and all this.
Yeah.
And I came across a website. It's based in Louisiana. So that leads me to believe that this movie is taking place in Louisiana. The other thing was that if you go to their store, you can order the soda itself, which I'm going to be on that, like, probably start on Monday. I'm going to go ahead and order me some. I heard that they come, certain orders come with 3 puzzle pieces.
What?
Yeah. I mean, they're doing puzzles, you know, in the bunker. And it's a, they're puzzle pieces that add together, like, to make the Eiffel Tower. If you look at the trailer again, there's something weird going on. I can't piece it together just yet, but there's a lot of focus on the Eiffel Tower. The girl has a shirt of an Eiffel Tower.
Mm-hmm.
There's various paintings in the backgrounds of Eiffel Towers.
Really?
Yeah. And then the puzzle pieces, you know, are part of an Eiffel Tower puzzle.
Yeah.
Now, the interesting part is that in their store, you know, in their store on the website, they have, what do they call it? Like a lifetime supply of Swamp Pop that you could buy. Like a long-term like supply.
If you're going to be in.
And it has almost like a biohazard sign on it.
Yeah.
And it says, you know, for those people that are looking to drink the best soda in the world or something for a long term. And it's like for $5,000, but it's sold out. It says it's sold out at the bottom. But then they have like cases of 4, cases of 38, and then they have like a mixed case that you could buy and stuff like that. So I thought that little piece of you know, information was interesting, that they weren't going to let you buy like the lifetime supply.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, because they already own it on the movie.
Yeah, but they have it there. I'm hearing stuff also that there could possibly be a monster, like somebody pieced together something and they showed like this monster. It almost looks like the Cloverfield monster, but it almost looks like fish-like, more fish-like this time. So maybe it's a different monster altogether. Yeah.
Well, because it's the new trailer says the evil takes many forms.
Yeah. See, and then they keep, you know, saying and reiterating that this is only like a blood relative of Cloverfield, of the other movie.
Yeah.
And they're looking at it more like it could be like an anthology series.
Could.
Where it's like every movie, it maybe has a monster, but it's that's the only way that it's kind of connected.
Okay.
With monster, you know, like a different monster every time. Kind of like the way, you know, you would have like Creepshow where they have like five different stories.
Okay, yeah.
They're not really connected, but they're all somewhat, you know. So, again, that was just another detail that I found. Everybody's still keeping very, you know, secretive about it.
Yeah, and it's not that far away.
And it's not that far away. So I feel like they're holding on to something major. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then there's other people that are saying, well, don't get your hopes up because maybe there's not even a monster at all.
Yeah.
I'm like, well, don't say that. Like,
ruining it.
Oh, you're ruining my dreams, man.
I knew it. I had a... We talked about this.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, you look in there and you notice anything?
Oh, man. I started, like, trying to pick apart every little scene. And that was the one thing that I noticed before I even found out about anything else, that the Eiffel Tower was a common thing in there, you know? Mm-hmm. And I'm sure that there... Oh, the other thing that I found out on that website is that they have, like, a little slogan, right? It says you can't drink just four on the top right, I think it is, of the website. That slogan is very similar to the Slusho slogan. Do you remember, like, they had, like, a slush drink in the original Cloverfield that would show up? J.J. Abrams, like, had it show up in Heroes?
I don't watch Heroes.
Well, I watched it here and there, and I don't remember seeing it, but I know I've seen pictures.
Mm-hmm.
He had to show up in Felicity when he was doing Felicity back in the day. And he had to show up in Super 8.
Oh, okay. I remember.
In there, too. Anyway, if you go to slusho.com, I think it might be slusho.jp.com, since it's like a Japanese website.
Yeah.
The slogan for them is, you can't drink just six. So that's another common thing.
Yeah.
Where, okay, this one says you can't drink just six. This one says you can't drink just four. When they say that, that means like, oh my God, like it's so delicious. You know, you just can't stop yourself.
You gotta drink more, yeah.
Now, they've said in the past with the original Cloverfield that the Slusho had something to do with some sort of like waste. Like chemical waste that disturbed the monster underwater. You know what I mean? And then they secreted it from like this rock, and they found out that it tasted so good. You know, so they added it with their drinks.
So that's what's in the barrel.
See, that could be.
Slusho.
Maybe.
I don't know. It's gonna open a
Bill Straw. But.
So what if, okay, you remember in the first movie, if you pay attention to where the boyfriend and girlfriend are at Coney Island, I think?
Yes.
And then if you notice in the background, you'll see
something fall.
Around the water.
Now, I can't pinpoint what that is. I've always thought it was...
Water monster.
I always thought, see, that could be it.
See, and the Cloverfield one that we know of...
Maybe that wasn't
even him.
Yeah. That's the one from the second movie.
It's a battle.
You don't know. I don't know. But it sounds that's a good theory. I like that though. I always thought that it was a monster coming down. Either that or like a satellite coming down and hitting something and waking it up or something underwater. You know, so it could be one of those two things.
Yeah.
I do like that theory though, that maybe that monster coming down was the one from this movie. You know what I mean? Because the picture that I saw, and I gotta look into it a little bit more on how they came across this. Or how they came about. They said that they pieced together something. Can't be the puzzle. But they pieced together something. And that it showed up as this monster. And this monster, it almost looked like it had like long arms and like almost like fin type things underneath.
Really?
Yeah. So,
Look that up right now.
Yeah, see if you can find it. But, yeah, I thought that was an interesting aspect. You know, the things are coming together little by little. And we're going to be covering it as I start, you know, finding more things out about it. We're going to be covering it more and more. But it's just this viral marketing. I knew it was going to kick in at some point, and now it's like full speed, you know. So we'll see how it goes from there, I guess.
I just saw that the drink you're talking about.
Slusho?
It's called Swamp.
Oh, something. Swamp Pop.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We'll go ahead and move on from that. If John finds anything, then we'll kind of cut back into that. But I saw something that came across my my Facebook feed the other day, and I was deeply I was appalled. I was appalled and taken aback by it, John. I really was. I was. And it kind of hurt my feelings in a way. I saw a trailer, and I was like, okay, what is this? So I kept watching it. Turns out it was a trailer for Cabin Fever, a remake of Cabin Fever. Now, if I remember correctly, I don't think it might have. It might be right at 10 years that it's come out.
Mm-hmm.
Or it might be like around 9-ish.
No, already?
Yeah. But that trailer was basically shot for shot the same movie as the original Cabin Fever. And it bugged the hell out of me, man. Because I think the original Cabin Fever movie still holds up, you know, for the most part. Give or take maybe like an effect or two.
Yeah.
And I like, kind of like the humor in it a bit. And then it's mainly horror after that. But it's funny in certain ways. And not to mention it has Sean from Boy Meets World. But
the cool guy.
I thought, you know, it was a decent movie, like the way it is. And then they go ahead and remake it. And I see from executive producer Eli Roth, I'm like, what the fuck? Like, why would you put your name on something like that? He didn't put his name on those other damn sequels, you know? Besides, like, you know, based on characters by Eli Roth type of thing. The other sequels were just fairly garbage for the most part. You said you saw the third one, right? The third one is a prequel.
It's the prequel.
Yeah.
So I haven't seen the first and the second. And I started to watch the third one, and I was like, you know what? It started to say things, and I haven't, like I said, I haven't seen them, and it started to say things, and I guess do little clips of happened.
Like, yeah.
I stopped it. I was like, I'm gonna watch the other two, then I'll get to this one.
The thing is, that movie though, it's almost like the first one, in a way. That prequel. Third one,
yeah.
And not to mention, and you probably didn't get this far. Yeah, Samwise Gamgee is in there. You probably didn't get this far. But there's this weird dildo fight at the end.
What?
Yeah. There's a weird dildo fight at the end. It's strange. Like, somebody's infected trying to, like, you know, go after somebody. And grabs a big old dildo.
Man.
Whacking him in the face. Weird. Very strange. I don't know why.
Okay, two things come to mind. Me, myself, and Irene, when the dude tried
to... I thought you were going to tell a personal story. Like, me, myself,
no,
like,
no,
I was,
no, no.
I was like, whoa.
No, you remember when she pulled it out?
Yeah.
And then, because Hank is fighting the bad guy, and then the bad guy beats up Hank, which is Jim Carrey.
That's right.
And then she whacks him in the head with the condom, the dodo. And then the other one was at Idiocracy. Remember on the car?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Remember?
Yes, I do remember.
Yeah.
But okay, back to the what we're talking about.
My bad.
Cabin Fever, though, it did not need to be remade. There was no reason for it. I don't think they should have even touched that movie. Maybe not yet. I would say they should have given it at least another good like 5 years before they did anything. And if you're gonna do it differently. From what I could tell, it was the same movie. You know, like I said, almost like shot for shot. There's a part where in the original, a girl's in the bathtub, and she just got, like, you know, recently infected.
Mm-hmm.
And she's shaving her legs. And as she's shaving her legs, skin is coming off and blood is still like, same scene was in the trailer. You know, the girl in the bathtub and all that stuff. And it's like, okay, if you're going to remake something, you got to do it kind of in a new way.
Yeah.
You know, in a fresh way. Not like that. It was no reason for it. And, you know, I hope that this doesn't... I know it's happened before, but I hope this doesn't, like, you know, start a new trend where that's all, you know,
that's quick happening. Remakes.
Yeah, quick remakes. They're like, okay, hey, let's just watch the original movie while we're filming so we can do what they're doing. At the same time, you know?
The reboot of Avengers
just started.
not even over yet.
But yeah, it bugged the hell out of me to see it, and I hope that it doesn't happen again. I hope, to be perfectly honest, I hope that this movie like bombs, you know, because there's no reason for it.
Well, the first one did all right, I guess, right?
I think it did like low-key all right, you know what I mean? Like,
okay.
It did okay at the theaters, and then it did really well, like, on DVD and Blu-ray and stuff.
Okay,
you know?
One of those movies.
Yeah. Okay, now on to another thing that, like, bothers me. I just saw that DC Comics is doing these, like, revamps for these Hanna-Barbera characters. You know the Hanna-Barbera cartoons, Space Ghost and Johnny Quest. They're doing comics for them, right? Mm-hmm. But they're kind of updating their look a little bit to have a little bit more modern. Johnny Quest looks, I think for the most part, they look okay, you know? They look pretty neat, I guess. Johnny Quest still has, like, the blonde hair with the black shirt.
Was it blonde or the white?
I think it was blonde. And then Haji still looks like Haji. He has a turban, even though it is stereotypical.
It is.
You know, but it's the character that you know from the past. Space Ghost still looks like Space Ghost.
Hell yeah.
So that's pretty awesome. I really liked Space Ghost back in the day. So, and they have, you know, comics, like a team-up comic with all the Hanna-Barbera characters in one. And then they have, like, the individual comics, like, you know, Johnny Quest and then Space Ghost. And then I saw Scooby-Doo. They have a Scooby-Doo book coming out, and it's called Scooby-Doo Apocalypse. I think that's what it's called.
I think I've seen this.
And they show Scooby-Doo, and I saw the photo, and I was immediately like, what? They show Scooby-Doo with like this visor, like a Google Glass type of thing over his eye, and you see emojis coming off of it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, that's just dumb. And then I look up a little bit more. Show Velma. Velma looks okay, I guess. Show Shaggy. Shaggy is the character that just made me want to throw my phone across the room. They have him very hipstery. With the pompadour hair. You know, the kind of high, poofy hair. A mustache. Like, with the curls at the end.
Yeah.
And he has tattoo sleeves.
Does?
Yes.
So he's not a hippie anymore.
He's a hipster.
He's the new age hippie.
I'm like, oh my God, man. Why? Like, why do you have to do that?
Yeah.
What's his name? The main guy. I can't remember his name now. Fred. He looked a little weird too. And so did the other girl. I can't remember her name either. But yeah, for the most part, it was just all wrong, man. Like, why are you doing that?
Yeah.
You know, I get trying to modernize them, but you're modernizing them to the point where they look stupid.
It's gonna bomb. It's gonna blow.
And I don't know what's up with DC Comics lately.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, they just announced also that now, from what I gather, they're not doing a reboot. Everybody like went like fucking crazy. Because Jim Lee had tweeted out something that said rebirth. And everybody's like, no. What do you mean? Like, please, you just rebooted everything.
Yeah.
Like, you just did the New 52 a while back. Then you just rebooted it again about a year ago.
Yeah.
And now everybody's saying that, well, you know, it's not really a reboot. But we're doing new number one issues all across the board.
Okay.
To go in tone with the movies that are coming out. DC movies that are coming out.
So that's okay, yeah.
And it's like, okay, no, like try to keep it separate. I thought they were doing fine right now. As much as I really don't like the New 52 very much, you know, give or take like select things like Batman. I like the Batman stories and stuff like that. They're redoing number ones all over again, I guess, to get new readers where they'd be like, okay, well, we'll start at number one, you know.
Okay. We're not,
yeah. But it just, other than, it makes no sense to me other than that. I remember back in the day when we were younger, it makes me sound old whenever I say back in the day, but when we were younger, number ones used to mean something.
Yeah.
You know? Number ones used to be the special, you know, the first issue. Like, oh my God, I got to get it. You know? They mean shit now.
You know what number ones mean to me now? That means number one doesn't mean anything, but that variant does.
That's what I was going to say. That's variants. Sense. Variants are going to be, they're going to have four variants for each book.
Well, okay.
Because they're redoing all 52 titles again in number ones.
Okay, like the Power Rangers.
Oh, yeah.
The Power Rangers
that
comic.
Honestly, that got kind of crazy.
Okay.
Prices and stuff like that.
The Power Rangers comic, they can't, oh, is it Zero? Zero, okay.
Zero, not even a number one.
They had, like, different, you know, covers, right? And those, I think they sold, but they weren't really, or they, no, I don't think they really did sell. The ones that did sell were the variant covers, which was the red, yellow, pink, blue, and black. And then two special ones, right? So the regular, there's five variants, but these are where all you see is from the from upper the neck torso, down, yeah. From the neck down to the morpher, the buckle, and you see each ranger, individual ranger holding
helmet.
I own four of those.
You got four of them?
I do.
Which one?
I own a pink, yellow, blue, and I just got the black one online for I'm happy I got it for $4.
That's not bad.
Online, any of those go for $25. Red Ranger goes for $30. And there's the other two special ones is the Green Ranger and the White Ranger. Now, see,
there's two more.
No,
there's two more.
Well, there's the one with but those are reprint.
The armored Red Ranger,
armored
with the shield.
Really?
Yep.
I didn't see that one.
The armored Red Ranger. That's the most that's the one that's going for the most. And then I think I saw that they had announced. I think this one's a reprint though. But I'm sure that one's going to go for a lot. It's Rita holding the Green Ranger's helmet.
Yeah. Okay. That's the second printing for the thing. I asked this guy. I went comic book hunting, dude. I went to three different comic book stores. One, not necessarily a comic book store, but they sold a bunch of board games and stuff like that. And Yu-Gi-Oh cards, Pokemon. And
okay.
Those type of games, you know.
Yu-Gi-Oh!
And,
stupid.
And, I went to, up north, on 59 North in Houston. There's a place called DNA Comics. I went there. That's where I found the Power Ranger ones. Went there. And the guy basically told me, not there. I went to another place, and this one was called Watchtower Comics. And I talked to a guy there named Mike, and the dude was telling me, oh, we're gonna get some more. And I was like, yeah. He goes, yeah, but we're getting only the variant prints. And I was oh, yeah? And I was like, well, great. You know, can I put... He goes, I can't put anything aside. What they're doing is they're ordering three sets of each one, and they're selling them all five like that.
Per set.
Because they don't want to get stuck with a bunch of yellow Rangers, a bunch of black Rangers.
I can understand that.
Yeah.
I give them that. I mean, but the thing that bothers me is... And I saw other people... Because I went on a Twitter, hashtag... hunt one time when they were coming out, and I just saw, I was trying to see everybody's reaction to them, and people were fucking pissed at some point because people were looking on eBay and they're going for $250 per set,
dude,
or something like that. And then another person's I just went to my local comic shop and got into a fight with the owner because he wants to that they just opened the case and they were putting the books out, and I saw the White Ranger comic, which is a very rare, you have to order a certain amount.
50 for the green store, and 100 for the
in order white. To get that one. And he was like, I saw him, and he was like, I asked him, can I grab it? He's like, no. No, we're putting this up for sale. And they sold it for putting it on sale for $100.
They're not supposed to do that.
You know?
They're not supposed, that's wrong. No wonder the dude got into an argument.
It's just whenever they unbox toys at a Toys R Us and there's a rare toy.
Yeah.
Just them saying, well, no, I'm going to pull this out and we're going to put it on sale for $75.
There's another comic book store I love to go to. It's called Third Planet. Okay. When they do get variants, when they know this is the golden ticket, they will bag it, border it, and they will put a different price on there. But the price of it, and I have not seen them pull this out and go, $200. No, it's always $18 to $20.
You know what I mean? And I bought it. What I think would be wise, and I'm going to go out, and this just came to me right now, and I'm going to go out and say it. And if you comic book shops out there are listening, I think what would be awesome would be, okay, you get a rare variant, right? You put it aside. Sure, okay. You don't put it on sale just yet. You put out an announcement, you know, on your Facebook page or whatever that you're going to have a raffle. How about that? And then you say $5 tickets or, you know, $10 tickets, whatever it may be, $2 tickets. You have people coming in spending, like, say, $10 on a bunch of tickets, and it's still a fair price for somebody if they grab it. You know what I mean? And you'll still make a lot of money, comic shops.
More money, yeah.
You know, it's like, how about you do something, make it an event.
I'm not going to say, I thought this was wrong. I'm not going to say which comic book store I went to that did this. But the guy mentioned, I said, yeah, we got two of the greens and one white. And the owner kept the green and white and then sold the green. And I was like, alright, whatever. I was, damn.
Yeah.
You know, and whatever. I figured, you know, just here, you know, but the dude wanted them, I guess.
The thing is that comic book shops and stuff, they tend to get greedy.
Yeah.
You know? And it's like, okay, you should think about what's better for your business. It's a business. It is a business.
Yeah, make money.
And I think the raffle idea, I think that's a great idea. I keep thinking about it. I'm like, they'll be making a pretty good amount of money off of it. And still giving, you know, their customer a fair shot, you know?
So, like, going back to the DC and all that stuff, I think that's what they're doing.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's trying to sell those number ones because, you know, that's what everybody wants is that. But it's just not generally just that number one. It's that special number one.
It's a special one.
I didn't know this. It is blew my mind about the Spider-Gwen comic. I was talking to one of the guys again at the comic book store, and he was like, because we're talking about this, just about how comic book, I picked up, it said the New Avengers, and I looked at it, and I was like, Jesus Christ, New Avengers? And I went and looked at it, and I saw She-Thor, and I saw She-Captain America, and
all these, She-everybody.
Yeah, there was a girl Captain America.
Yeah, I think they have, like, A-Force, I think is, like, all the women Avengers or something like that.
Well, this one, it was, you know, men and women, and I was like, oh, come on, man. And he goes, if you don't like the new stuff, man, we got some older stuff over here. And I'm like, no, I was just curious. So I just wanted to see.
Yeah.
And I was like, I'm not really too crazy about what's coming out right now because it's just all the change. And he's like, well, I don't know about the change, man, because, you know, everything, you know, like right now, Marvel's sticking to, like, their stories. Like, they're still going and everything. I was like,
they just rebooted them. What are you talking about?
Yeah, you know, in my mind, I'm like,
Secret Wars, like, changed, you know, everything.
And then he brought up the Spider-Verse. And he started telling me about Spider-Verse and all that stuff. I was like, I more or less, yes, no, not kind of know about it. Basically, there's the, I guess it's like a monster or something that's taking the souls of each Spider-Man in different universes.
Spider-Verse, yeah.
And so all the Spider-Mans they band together to, you know, defeat this, right? Well, that's where Gwen Stacy comes from, the Spider-Man. Well, he goes, yeah, man, if you have Spider-Verse number 2, where she makes her first appearance, and he showed me the cover, and I was like, I have this one.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, you have this one. I said, yeah. He goes, you have this one. I said, yeah. He goes, dude, that thing's worth like $500 or $600 or $700. I'm like, no way.
Yeah.
He goes, but you got to be sure this is the first one, because the first one, and this is why I brought it up, because he said actually this is where a lot of people got pissed, is that when they came out with that comic, selected comic books in selective cities or states, whatever, they only made 150 of that cover.
Per state or whatever.
Yeah.
Per...
No, just 150.
Oh, in total.
In total, 150 of them. And so if you go online, look it up. That Spider-Verse number one or whatever was Gwen Stacy on the cover. Those comics are going.
That's insane. I still think it is insane to me how popular Spider-Gwen got.
Yeah.
Because I remember when I first heard that they were doing Spider-Gwen, I'm like, oh, okay.
The hell that happened?
I'm like,
Peter Parker bitter.
I started reading into, like, you know, the Spider-Verse version of her, like, what happened, or, I'm like, okay, I get it, but just an alternate version of Spider-Man. Okay, all right, fine. And next thing you know, Spider-Gwen. I'm like, oh my God, like, what's going on?
So check this out. So is it the one with the black background? I said, yeah, I got that one. And I'm flipping. I'm like, oh my God, I got a fucking...
Yeah.
So the thing is, that comic book right now is on its fifth print.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it may be a little bit more because they got the black.
Yeah.
And they got the pink, yellow, blue, green, and I don't know if there's a purple. There's a purple, so it's on a sixth print. So I went and I looked at it, and I had the second printing one.
Oh.
And he was like, you know, if you have one, dude, hang on to it because, you know. But, I mean, how pissed can everybody be right now for the lucky people? And then let's say those lucky people are the ones that are trying to scam everybody and make the money. And because, dude, look, $500. CGC. You know, $500, dude. I buy these comics because I love them.
Yeah,
I want them.
Yeah,
but not to. That pissed me off, and I'm just learning this now that they did that 150 issues and.
See, and that's the thing is that you know I think one of the reasons I stopped collecting comics at one point was because of all this.
What's worse now?
When I remember when I was trying to get the Astonishing X-Men number one,
mm-hmm.
I was calling comic shops everywhere trying to get it.
Which one's that?
That's the one that Joss Whedon had wrote, the guy that did Buffy at the time, before he directed Avengers and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And I was trying to look for that one, and I found the original cover. It has just Wolverine's claws just on the cover. Black background, Wolverine's claws. That's the original print, original first printing. And then they have a variant where they show Wolverine kind of like with claws out and it's like red background and stuff like that. I got that one too. And then there was another one where it was, I think, all the X-Men on the cover like kind of jumping out. And that one was the one where certain shops had to order so many to get it. I think they call it like the diamond variant. And I was calling everywhere looking for it. And everywhere I called was like, well, yeah, we got it, but we're putting it on sale for $200.
Jesus Christ.
Or, yeah, we got it, but, you know, it's like $150. Or, and then I got one. I was like, why are you looking for variants for? They're not worth anything. You're better off just not even collecting comics. I'm like, you want my business, right? That was the one person that threw me off. But after that, I was just like, okay, this is getting crazy. You know, and it sucks because... I was kind of like at the point where I stopped collecting comics for like price reasons,
mm-hmm.
like for collectible reasons. I kept collecting comics because I just wanted them. I thought they were cool.
They are.
You know, I thought certain issues were cool. You know, the whatever their worth wasn't even in my mind.
Yeah.
You know, and it was cool if you ended up with one that
I see
was,
what you mean. I
yeah.
Know. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then it was cool if you ended up with one that ended up being, like, you know, like, really worth something.
Uh-huh.
But those days are, like, long gone. You can't... You go to a comic store and you grab one off the shelf and you're looking at the original, you know, price or original print. It's not going to be worth much, you know.
Mm-hmm.
All the ones are going to be picked out, you know, beforehand. So it's kind of like... You might as well just collect comics for what you want to collect it for.
Yeah.
You know, to hell with the money thing. So we're going to, I guess, move on from, well, maybe lean right into our childhood with, we were talking about, you know, how the Scooby-Doo thing fucking made me flip, right?
It's too
yeah.
And you really bothered
me. It really did, because I was like, it's fucking Scooby-Doo, man.
Like, the cartoon they got going on right now sucks.
Why does Shaggy have a mustache like that? But anyway, we're going to move on from that to another something from our childhood. It was reported that they're going to be doing a Nicktoons movie. Yeah, and I was like, well, no, a Nicktoons. And I was like, okay, Nicktoons. I'm like, okay, how are they going to do that? And they're going to do something that hasn't been done in a while. They're going to do it kind of like... they classified it as Nickelodeon's version of Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Oh, really?
So they're going to have all the Nicktoons in one movie, and I'm going to assume that there's going to be, like, actual people in it, too.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, but you're going to have people like Ren and Stimpy, Hey Arnold, Doug, you know,
Rugrats, all of them,
Angry Beavers, and all that, you know, in one movie. And I was like, okay, I can kind of dig that, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I was like, okay, they didn't fuck everything up for me. Yeah. So my nostalgia meter is still, like, you know, leveled.
You know what? That's kind of that's kind of interesting to hear. I like that. I like that that idea. I mean, and not so much like
like, okay, like
what they did with the Looney Tunes one.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. If you just throw them in one movie together and just do stuff, then I don't know. But the way that they said it, they're like, okay, well, this is gonna be our version of Who Framed Roger Rabbit. I'm like, okay, I can like get
that.
With that.
That's pretty cool.
Now obviously it's gonna be kid oriented.
Yeah.
You know, but
SpongeBob.
Oh. I think everybody that's our age is gonna probably take their kids or go see it themselves, yeah, because those shows still are very popular,
mm-hmm,
you know, with younger generations.
You know, they're showing Kenan and the Kale still?
Yeah, they started doing like a programming block where, yeah, they just show all the old 90s stuff again.
Yeah, my kids, like, they know Good Burger. They love funny. That show, you know what I mean?
I have yet to show any of my kids. Well, I think, you know, maybe Dominique, my older one, she knows about Doug and stuff, like, and Hey Arnold.
She's Hey Arnold! Those.
Yeah,
and then like Leave It to Steven, like, or what? Leave It to Steven?
Even Steven?
Even Steven, yeah.
That was Disney though.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah, it was live action.
Oh man.
Yeah, it was.
The dude, the little boy with the tattoo on his arm, looking my girl dance on my arm. Remember?
Oh, what was? No, that was something else. I can't remember what that was. I know what you're talking about though.
That was Pete and Pete. Yeah, that was Nicktoons.
Yeah, it was on.
So like, let's say he's old now. You know what I mean? He's all like, "Hey, check it out."
I'd like, you know what? That would be kind of cool to have like the live action shows also like in
with
there.
The new characters, yeah, in there. Yeah. See,
that'd be kind of cool.
Like Doug goes into like Good Burger to buy a burger,
man,
and they're still like,
"See." And I've wanted to see like a Doug movie. I love Doug.
Didn't he?
That was maybe
the Power in the Underwear. Right?
Oh yeah, they did.
They did have a movie.
They did. It was like Quail Man or something.
Quail
like
Man, yeah, he had the belt on his, yeah, head. Yeah.
But, man, like, Doug was one of my favorites. Rugrats I watched up until they were, like, I don't know. I think
Ren and Stimpy was that cartoon you could not believe.
Yeah, like, stuff got on air.
On air.
Also, Rocko's Modern Life was, like,
Rocko,
too.
Rocko was crazy, man.
I look back at it now.
The SNES game was crazy, yeah, too. You lost a sock in the dryer, and he went after it.
Yeah.
And then the whole game was in the dryer.
No, well, not just crazy like that, but there was, I remember going back to see a scene one time where there was like, was it Rocko? Yeah, where he was in the house and then like these motorcycle people came,
mm-hmm,
and they were very obviously lesbians.
Okay.
Lesbian, like women, motorcycle gang.
Uh-huh.
And they, oh my God. Okay. They went into the house,
uh-huh,
and they grabbed all the rugs and started chewing on them.
Rug munchers.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh no. No.
No way.
Yes, I'm like, they did not do that. Oh, holy shit. I think it was Rocko. It might have been another one, but.
Oh, man.
Yeah. And, oh, my God, man. It was like one of those things. I saw it. I'm like, oh my God, I never noticed that.
Wait, you seen this win just recently?
Like, yeah.
Because,
yeah,
back then you would have been like.
Back then I was like, oh, okay.
That's funny.
Why are they eating carpet? And then I get older, I'm like,
oh.
And there's a lot of instances like that. Ren and Stimpy had a lot of those in there,
yes,
too.
They did.
And I had seen that there was one point where Ren and Stimpy got kicked off of like Nickelodeon. Or they got canceled, and then the creator was like, he was mad.
Yeah.
So he went and put it on another network, but he made it really raunchy.
Damn.
And there's like an episode or two out there that are really like dirty. Like really dirty.
I seen a scene where Ren has a saw, like, lowered to the buckle, like, yeah, where I guess where his dong would be,
and he's like,
and Stimpy is bent over with a log on top of his ass, and he's like, he's going at it, right, and then he stops. He goes, I can't do it. And then Stimpy turns around and goes, please, Ren, just do it harder.
Okay, I think you know what, and I think I remember
doing
that.
No way, I remember.
What are you doing? And he's like, all right, I'm going to give it to you hard and deep. I'm like, no way. I miss those cartoons, but no.
Oh, my God. But yeah, no.
I had no idea.
Like, if you start watching them again, you'll pick out a whole lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, floored. I'm like, oh, I'm not letting my kids watch it. Oh,
like, oh my God.
You remember when he, the creators, the Renaissance people did the Tenacious D one?
Oh, yeah.
Fuck you.
Yeah. That one was bad.
And it was the art, you know, and it was
same,
cool.
Same kind of art. Yeah. So, the Nicktoons movie.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, I mean, okay. The way I look at it, if they do it right, it's going to be directed by... It's going to be directed by the director from Napoleon Dynamite. So I was like, okay, well, that kind of... I guess I can see that because it's that right amount of weird. You know, Napoleon Dynamite was random as hell.
It was.
It was so random and strange. But in a way, that's kind of what's needed for a Nicktoons movie
yeah,
like
yeah.
that.
Yeah, you couldn't even tell Napoleon Dynamite was...
It didn't have a story.
No, it didn't.
It was just a bunch of random things put together.
And it didn't have, like, a set year either.
No.
Or, you know what I mean?
I kept wondering, when does this take place?
Okay, you know, like, Batman Adventures? I could never figure out what that was.
I know. Because it's, like, 1950s, but everything's futuristic.
Whatever.
I could never.
Everyone around in suits and
yeah.
You know what I mean? It was just old-ass cars.
But no, that was my exact like thing about it. I was like, I could not pinpoint when it took place. Do they dress like that on purpose? You know?
Yeah.
And it's like 2010 or something, like 2005 or 7.
When it came out.
But I feel like, you know, because he also did like Nacho Libre and all that.
He did?
Yeah, so it's like those type of weird, quirky movies. I think if he were to do it, I think it would come out.
He'll pull it off.
Yeah, I think it would come out pretty good. So I will have to wait and see. They just announced it, so there's no like release date just yet. But I'm interested to see what happens. They haven't even announced like who is gonna be in it per se.
Yeah.
So I'm figuring that they're gonna just like, hey, let's just grab everybody and throw it in there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as long as it doesn't start Brendan Fraser, I think we're okay.
Man, I like him.
So we're going to move on from that to the Legacy Thunder Megazords. We've been waiting for them. We've talked about them before on the podcast. We've been waiting for them for a while. And I started seeing more and more pictures. And then next thing you know, I saw a picture. Hey, I saw it in my local Toys R Us in Sacramento, California. $200. I was like, oh, shit.
Man.
The box looks awesome. The box looks freaking awesome.
It does, man. It really does.
Now, I saw, like, a full review on it. And the box is just about as long as the Titanus box. Yeah, it's not as wide. It's, like, maybe half.
Mm-hmm.
But it includes all five Zords in there, including the Red Dragon Thunder Zord. The Red Dragon Thunder Zord... from what I could tell, looked a little thinner.
Oh, really? Well, yeah, because it has to fit inside.
Yeah, a little thinner, a little smaller, but it's very articulate. Like the neck and the tail and all that
mm-hmm.
stuff, very articulate. Not all of it is metal, like,
yeah.
You know, like we would have thought or whatever.
Yeah.
But they look amazing. The other Zords are, you know what? I think if you put them all together, like you form the Thunder Megazord.
Yeah.
It's about the same size as the original.
Really?
Yeah, the original is pretty heavy.
It's pretty big, yeah. Hell yeah.
So I was pretty happy about that. Because usually with the legacy versions, they're a little smaller.
A little small, yeah.
You know? So I was like, okay, that's really awesome. Everything is like, man, like, no stickers. Everything is etched in there.
Already on there, yeah.
The Firebird one, amazing. It has like the detail on the wings and all that stuff.
The tail. Remember
yeah.
The tail goes a part of the sword.
Man, it was awesome. Now there was something that I saw. Remember how you formed the Mega Tiger Zord?
Okay, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the Firebird goes onto the
arm
part. There it doesn't clip on like the old one did. It has an attachment, like a little black attachment that you clip onto the bottom and then you snap it onto the arm kind of thing. And then, you know, fold the wings across.
That's cool.
It looks awesome though. Man.
You've already seen that version?
I've seen it. I've seen it. I saw a video that somebody, because as soon as like people got it, they're like, "Well, let me put up a, you know, a review, like an unboxing type of thing."
Yeah.
And it blew me away. I was like, "Man!" But the price tag, though, man.
Yeah, they $200.
That is what like hurts in a way.
That's a lot, man. That's...
I mean, I'm sure it's gonna go down. I'm sure. I mean, look, the Titanic.
How much did Titanic go down?
Titanic went down to. I got it for $99.
What?
Yeah.
Where?
I had to go to Humble.
Oh.
Which is like an, and if you are not here in Texas or Houston, Humble is about like an hour away.
Up north. Yeah.
Yeah.
Of Houston.
An hour drive. And I found a Toys R Us, they had it, went up there, grabbed it. There's a little dent on the top.
Yeah.
But I was like, oh, I can deal with that. I can deal with that for $100, man.
Yeah.
You know, went back home, got back home, and I said to myself, I'm not fucking doing this again. I'm not driving out there again.
You know what?
Let it happen again.
Watch the same store get the damn Thunder Megazord.
And I'll be like, bye. Right. I'll be back. I'll go to Humble. But
during the damn podcast.
I honestly really got lucky because I was the last one in the area. Like within a 60, 70 mile radius or something like that. And it was a little damaged, and that's why it hadn't sold. So I was like,
but for $100, because that dude, that's half, 50% off,
you know. And
damn, I think I would have done that,
dude. But I'm hoping that it goes down, even if it's like 179.
What about the blaster? Have you heard anything about the blaster? Has it gone down?
The blaster, I think, is still like $80, which is about the same. I think that's about how much it was, right? I'm waiting for that one to go down a little bit before I get it.
I picked it up, man. I was like, I was afraid. And I picked it up, and I walked away, and I saw a dent, went back, put it back, and grabbed another one.
I'm still waiting for that one to just go down just a little bit at least, you know, so I can be like, okay, I can deal with that, you know. $80 for a gun, I really want it, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But it was like, and it hit right at the Christmas time where I was like, I can't do it right now.
Scratching.
You know?
Just scratching.
But
I hear you.
But they're going to be doing the Falcon Zord, Legacy Falcon Zord. And that's coming out, I think, by, if I heard correctly, like April or May. Yeah. And I was looking at the photos of the Legacy Falcon Zord, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I noticed a lot of things on there. Certain clips, certain like little, you know, inserts that leads me to believe that they are already going to be planning the Ninja Megazord and the Shogun Zords. Because I saw the clips like on the inside of the wings.
Yeah.
For the Shogun, whenever it folds in like that. And then I saw the clips on the back as well. So that's going to be coming as well. That's the Bandai's looking to make us all broke. Apparently.
Yes. David, I just... breaking news.
Breaking news?
Yes. All right, check it out. The Swamp Cola thing that David was talking about. All right, there's your picture right there, right? With your three puzzle pieces.
Three puzzle pieces.
See, there goes your... Where am I going? Right here. There goes your... That's the Swamp Cola. There's the three puzzle pieces. Now, check this out. If you back out of here...
Uh-huh.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Look, zoom in. What do those puzzle pieces look like?
Me, they look like the Eiffel Tower.
Okay.
Okay, he's looking. They did the puzzle.
Somebody did the puzzle.
Sure. That's the full puzzle. From all those puzzle pieces put together, it's the Eiffel Tower. So, is there an attack?
Is there something in the picture?
Look in the middle or something.
That you would see? I don't know. I think we're just going to have to
keep looking. Yeah, we're going to have to keep looking on that.
I'm going to take a screenshot of this.
But we're going to keep on that, of course. And if we come out with any details, we'll put them out on our Facebook page.
Basically, you're what you were saying is, you know, probably like right on the nose is what...
So you said it has something to do with France.
Maybe.
Is there a monster attack there?
28 weeks later, the infection... The infection, like the monsters attacking, although the infected start biting the monsters, you know?
No? Anybody? No?
I can't get it.
But the thing is, and it's funny because it's the Eiffel Tower. What other main attraction was hit during the first movie? Statue of Liberty.
Statue of Liberty, yeah.
Those two, the Statue of Liberty and Eiffel Tower, are connected in
beacons. A way. They came from the same place. They
came from France.
They came to copper.
No, I'm serious, though. I'm not. France gave us our Statue of Liberty.
They gave us Cloverfield.
They gave us. That's it. We solved it.
You damn me. Let's go home. Kill y'all.
But, yeah, so, I mean, right there, actually, I hadn't seen that. So that's pretty interesting that they actually did the whole puzzle now. 550, what does that mean? 550 pieces in that puzzle that they're doing in the trailer.
550 pieces, and then when you go online, it says you can only have three, but then the other one in Japan says you can only have six. Three and six make what, nine? Nine and 550 is what, 559? What does that mean? Cloverfield 10? This is some good beer.
You're gonna see me in 2 weeks with a big old whiteboard on the wall on my face. The pen is blue. The pen is blue. God damn. The goddamn pen is blue.
It's seven. He's all written on his face.
Anyway, so yeah. So I mean that's interesting. There's stuff everywhere that only people can speculate or try to dig into. I'm going to let people do all the math work because I'm not good at math.
So. I don't like math.
Right? So on from that to on from the Thunder Megazord stuff to the new Sentai that's going to be premiering this February in Japan.
All right.
They're called Zyuger, if I pronounce that correctly. Zyuger.
Okay.
They're kind of going back to the animal type of, you know, format. The helmets look awesome.
Really?
I feel like I have the same feeling that I did with Ninja, you know, last year, where I was like, man, like, the costume looked pretty cool. And then I looked at the Zords, like the mecha that they have, the Zords. I'm like, oh, I don't know. But these are more so, like, I'm like, I don't think I'm going to pick these up.
No?
I want to, just because they're like, you know, it's the new Sentai coming out. But basically, each of their like Zords are cubes. They're three cubes. It's three that come in the main one, as mm-hmm. opposed to like five that usually come together.
Yeah.
And they fold out, and literally, it looks like Minecraft.
Ah, gross.
Yes. And when you connect them all together, it looks like they're just cubes stacked on each other. You put something in, the arms come out. And there's no, like, separate legs.
Yeah.
It's just the cube is the two legs. They don't move. So I'm like, I can't see myself spending $80 on...
getting into that.
On something like that. You know, and then they have other ones that are coming, like the auxiliary Zords, you know, like the Ninja one had, like, the elephant.
Okay.
It's up there that kind of adds on to there.
Yeah.
They have other ones that are like a white tiger. And they have, like, a giraffe.
All right.
And they have some other stuff.
What is it? You can turn it into a sword?
But it's all... I think it does.
Oh.
But it's all the same thing, though. They're all cubes. And they just, like... The giraffe has, like, a little head sticking out.
Like sound waves. Basically, like, sound waves tapes. Like, you... It turns into a saber tooth, you know.
But they're all very basic.
Laser beak. Yeah, and they're very basic, but it... You could tell it was a fucking cassette.
See, but those look kind of cool, though. I'll give those that. Those are still look pretty cool looking. I just don't like the fact that they're trying to, you know, do the whole Minecraft type of pixel.
Well, maybe that's what they're going after. After our little ones.
Oh, man. I don't know.
Saban.
It's just disappointing to me.
Okay.
I wish they could have done something different.
You said about the suits, their outfits. Okay, the Dino Charge kind of, like, I don't like them. I mean,
You know what? I liked them at first. I think I'm getting kind of tired of
that. That little floating mouth shit, go away. You know?
Floating mouth.
Oh, that little floating gray piece in the front.
In the front?
I mean, because it probably would look plain and dumb as shit if it was just all black. But then they just threw it in there just to give it a look. This is where my mouth goes.
Yeah.
But, I mean, like... Look what they did with the Mighty Morphin, you know, the character, like the saber tooth, the two.
Basically like the head is like, you know.
Yeah,
like
it was chewing on your head. You know what I mean? I couldn't.
Stuff like that I like, and that's kind of what these look like in a way, where it looks like the head is like on the helmet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the newer ones, but the costumes look remind me a lot of like Jungle Fury, where they're very like plain.
Yeah.
But then they have like a picture of a lion.
Oh, okay.
On it.
You didn't know? Jungle Fury
or like, a picture of a shark?
Didn't like the Red Ranger have like the Charlie Brown?
He had like little stripes on the side.
I remember. I remember now. Okay, I got that one mixed up with somebody else. But okay.
Yeah, but I'm not sold on these at all, and I don't think I'm gonna get them. I would like if I had people saying, "Hey, yeah, get them. I really want to see a review on them. I really want to see you do an unboxing." Then I'd be like, "Okay, fine."
I just thought about something.
But for personal, no.
I don't mean to change the subject or anything like that, but. Have you heard anything? Have you pre-ordered your Twilight Princess?
No, I was just looking at it yesterday.
I pre-ordered mine last year. And I haven't heard anything. And I forgot when it's supposed to come out. Okay.
It's still a couple months. And they also...
They forgot me.
They're also coming... they're also doing a strategy guide with it, too. A hardcover strategy guide.
I'm going to buy that.
$20, not bad.
I'm gonna buy that.
I would say buy it
because hardcover.
Okay. Just like all the other ones, buy it because it's gonna they're gonna sell out quick, and then they're gonna end up going for like $80-$90. That's why I try to buy everything Zelda right when it comes out. Yeah. Because other than that, then you have all the scalpers that try to jack up the prices.
Yeah, I get you. That's, I had to ask, man, because David's real on top of
Zelda stuff. Yes. Now, there is this this site called Rose Colored Gaming. They do, like, custom... They do custom games. I think we've talked about them before in the past. Custom games, custom,
Game Boys.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have talked about like that. Stuff
like that. Well, they put something out the other day, and I was like, oh, man, I got to jump on this. And I think I'm going to do it probably this coming week. Hopefully, I hope they didn't sell out. But they're 3DS stands. To showcase your 3DS.
Really?
And it's custom ones for each Zelda 3DS that's come out. So you have one, it's just clear plastic, and it has the little hooks, and you just slide it in there, so it's kind of like on display.
Yeah.
And it has a little plate at the bottom. It says Legend of Zelda Triforce Heroes. Basically, or Legend of Zelda A Link Between Worlds.
Like what would hold up like your Nook or something, or like an iPad or something.
Okay. But it looked really neat. And they're not that expensive. They're like $15.
That's not bad.
Yeah, so it's not bad at all. But they only limited it to... they made 200 of each one.
Oh, shit.
So once they do that, since they're custom and they're done kind of like that, once they're sold out, they're out.
Over, yeah.
They also did a custom game for Nintendo. And it was The Legend of Link. And it's like a hack that somebody made of the original Legend of Zelda, but with the graphics completely redone, so it doesn't look like the original Legend of Zelda. And it's like new dungeons, new everything. It's like a brand new game. And it looks fucking amazing.
Man.
Like, it's all gold. It has like the Triforce logo like cut out in the middle, and it's like see-through. Like, it's clear, and then it has like a gold in the inside too.
Damn.
It looks so awesome, dude. And that sold out. Like, it came in a whole package. Like, with the box, the game, a poster, something else. It was, like, a couple of other things. And it went for, like, I think $150. Something like that.
Damn.
And it sold out like that. And now you see people on eBay trying to sell them for, like, $600,
$700. Oh, my God.
$800. Yep. It's crazy.
That's ridiculous.
I mean, they look amazing. If you're like a major Zelda collector, and you got the cash,
go for it.
Get them right when they come out or something. Go for it. But other than that, like casual, I consider myself a collector.
Mm-hmm.
We consider ourselves collectors, but not to the point where I'm gonna spend $800 on a game.
That's too damn much, man.
They look awesome and all, but no. And on that note, we're gonna go ahead and end this episode of the Bot Squad podcast. Thank you guys for checking us out here on Periscope. If you stream us on Periscope, and if you're watching on YouTube, thank you guys for watching as well and sticking with us through this whole hour and somewhat. I don't blame you if you fast forward a little bit. again, if you're downloading and listening to us on iTunes and SoundCloud, thank you as well. Leave us a review on iTunes if you can. Give us a 5-star, because why wouldn't you give us a 5-star rating?
Shit.
And then maybe throw a little comment on there as well. It helps us out. It helps us get our podcast even higher up on the list, as you could say, I guess, if you could say that. You can visit me on cinemadeviant.com all the time. There's movies, news, reviews, trailers, all that stuff. Giveaways as well. Facebook.com/cinemadeviant. Like that page there. Follow me on Twitter @cinemadeviant. Instagram, cinemadeviant. Tumblr, cinemadeviant. I don't know how to use it. Snapchat. I'm still trying to figure out Snapchat, but I'm there too. Cinema Deviant.
It's going to become another Tumblr?
Yeah, kind of. Probably. And what you got as far as your social?
Instagram, BobBang94. And Twitter is Spawn94EW.
Yes, sir.
And our Facebook.
Facebook page.
The Botchball Podcast Network.
This past weekend, we took a trip to the Dirt Mall.
Yes, we did.
And there's some photos up there. We're probably going to do another trip pretty soon.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know when exactly, but pretty soon. And we'll try to do some video for you guys over there.
Yeah.
And take more pictures as well. So
yeah, this time it was just like,
it was kind of like the trial run.
It was a walkthrough, yeah. And it was more talking about and making fun of shit and everything.
Oh, man.
And,
you know what? And we laughed so much that morning. We got up and we went at 8 o'clock in the morning. We laughed so much. I kept thinking to myself, these people probably think we're drunk.
Yeah.
It was hilarious.
Some crazy people there.
But yeah, so anyway, look, keep an eye out for that. Again, like that Facebook page. We got stuff going on there as well. And we will catch you next time. Bye.